Hi everyone, welcome to Rose Hip Knits podcast. I believe this is episode 54. My name is Hannah and you can find me as Rose Hip Chick on Ravelry and on Instagram. This is a podcast mainly about knitting, but I do also do some crochet, spinning. I do have a shop on Etsy where I sell my hand-dyed yarn, so sometimes I show some of my dyeing adventures on this podcast. I record my podcast from Northern Tasmania, where I live with my husband and two girls. I am originally from Sweden, so I may sound like I have quite a strong Australian accent, but I do have a limited vocabulary and I can sometimes sound not stupid, but yes, I do not always find it the easiest with finding my words in English. So if you didn't know it, that's why I'm from Sweden. Thank you for joining me. Today we are back in my studio. And it's not a very warm day outside. It's autumn here. All the leaves on the trees are now yellow or have fallen off. And we've had quite a bit of rain recently, but it's not raining at the moment, which I'm very happy about because it makes all the difference with how warm it feels. So yes, that's where we're at in my studio. And yes, I thought I'd take some time to sit down with you with my cup of tea and talk to you about what I've been up to. Yes, we do have a Ravelry group and you can find that just by searching for Rose Hip Knits podcast. We don't have any knit alongs or anything like that going on at the moment. I don't have any ideas for that at this point. If you have any suggestions, just please send me a message or put a comment down below if you have any ideas. Yes. Last time I announced the winners for the Aussie Along. Thank you to the winners that were in contact with me. Those prizes from Deanne of Adaday Design have been sent out to you. I'm still waiting for one winner to get in touch with me, so I'll give you a little bit more time. But if you haven't watched the last episode and you entered the Aussie Cowl, yes, have a look at the last episode. And again, I would like to say a big thank you to Deanne of Adaday Design for donating some patterns for prizes, and to Nicole of Cowl Girl Collective who donated some stitch markers. That was very, very generous. Okay. Oh, the sun's coming out outside. It's very nice. So today, I have some knitting to share with you. I have some spinning actually, not a lot to tell you, but you can see right there. I have two bobbins filled there. I've been doing some spinning. And I thought towards the end of the episode, I'll show you a bit of my latest dyeing and just show you what's in my shop at the moment. It's not something that I do in every episode. I don't always have a shop update or anything like that. Sometimes I'll just share a bit of what I've been dyeing. If it's something new and some new technique or something, I like to share with you. But today, because I have quite a lot of new things in the shop and some of you might find it interesting to have a look, I'll go through some of the skeins that are in the shop at the moment. So I'll let you know and then you can just skip that part if you're not interested. Yes, so that's what's up in this episode. I do have some ideas for other things to include in my episodes. I've been thinking about having a little section called yarn research, because I have been doing quite a bit of researching and trying out new yarns, new Australian yarns, and it's knowledge and information that I like to share with more people. The problem I find at the moment is that my episodes are running so long, even though I always say I want to keep it short. So adding that bit of extra might make them a bit too long, but we'll see. If I get through the other things today, and it hasn't been taking a very long time, I might record a little section about a new yarn that I have been looking into. Okay, let's get going. I have a new mug. I just got it at Target the other day. $2 of happiness for me. What I'm wearing. Let me see. Can I remember what I'm wearing? Oh, I know what I'm wearing, but what they're called. This is my cardigan that I made out of Bendigo Woolamule Stella in amethyst colorway. Is it called the Honey Cardigan or something like that? I can't remember. It's a design by Amy Miller. And it's just a straight down without buttons. I always fold up the sleeves because it does tend to grow as you wear it. And, grows longer both in the body and the sleeves. I don't wear this cardigan leaving the house. It's more of a comfy being at home cardigan. And it's very nice and comfortable. The cowl is the honey cowl. I can't remember who designed it. It's a free pattern on Ravelry. And I made this in my hand spun. And the hand spun is Tasmanian Merino. And it's so soft and really beautiful. I find it a little bit hard to wear this because it is just that little bit... It's like a size in between 2 loop and 3 loop, so it just feels a little bit too long for just 2 loops, but it's too short to make it 3 loops. And yes, it has like a slip stitch textured pattern, but it is so soft, so it's beautiful to have around the neck. But I do feel a bit like I'm not really sure about what it looks like, so sorry if I'm fiddling with that. So that's what I'm wearing. It's a season for hand knits, definitely. Okay, I have finished one item since I last spoke to you, and that is the volcano hat. This is a free pattern on Ravelry, and I can't remember the designer again. Sorry, I didn't make very good notes today. Everything that I'm working on is linked in my Ravelry project pages, so you can find me there by I'm Rosie Chick. And I do put show notes on rosehipknitspodcast.blogspot.com. I have been trying to put notes in the comments on YouTube, or not in the information box or description box on YouTube, and I've tried to do it in a thread in Ravelry, but doing it on the blog at the moment is easiest for me, and then I'll just link to the blog in those other places. Anyway, you'll be able to find a link to this pattern somewhere. It's a volcano hat. I knitted for my girl who's turning 7 on Thursday. I knitted for her, and we dyed the yarn together one weekend. I have the rest of the yarn my muddlings bag, which I really love. So this is the rest of the yarn. I used about half the skein. So this is my Victoria sock yarn base that we dyed. So it's different purples with a bit of a blue in there, I'd say, and pink. So I knit that. I did the brim double length so that she will be able to fold it up, because I was a bit concerned that it was quite stretchy and quite large, and I thought if she has that extra with the folded brim, it would be a bit more snug on her head, and then it can grow with her. Basically, I knit this on 2 millimeter needles. I am a very loose knitter, and yes, it was not the greatest knit, but it was quite fun and easy to just keep going. So I did that. She's very happy with it, and she's this type of child that will, when you put knitwear on her, she will just take it off straight away and saying that it's itching or it's too hot or something. But this one I put on her and she left it on. So that's a really good thing. It is a very soft yarn. So yes, I finished that, and that will go really well with the purple mittens that I made for her recently. If you remember, I only have my own ones here, but I made these mittens in different colors for all of my family. I designed a pattern. It's being tested at the moment, so I have a purple pair of those that will go really well with her new beanie. And I have half a skein, so I'm thinking about maybe making a pair of socks for my youngest, because I have made quite a few pairs of socks for my eldest daughter, so it's time for my youngest. That's something I've finished, and then I am working on a few things. Did I cast on anything new? No, not yet, but I have been. Oh yes, I did cast something new on. I'll show that first. So I saw on Instagram that Wool Gatherings is having a knit along. I think it's called Warm Up Others Knit Along or something like that. It starts today actually on the 22nd of May. It's a knit along where you knit beanies and scarves and mittens and things like that to donate for, I think, homeless people and other people in need. And I can't remember, it probably goes on for about 4 weeks, and they have a donation point where you can send your items. But when I read about it, it just gave me an idea that I should really use some of the single skeins in my stash. I have a lot of DK weight single skeins that I don't really have a project for. I don't really know what to use them for. I think I was thinking that they would be good for a hat or something like that, but we all have hats now in my family, and yeah, so I thought I'll just cast on for a beanie, and just even if it's not part of the knit along for the wool gatherings, I'll be able to give it to a friend, or I'm not sure if there's anyone around in my area that will collect knitwear for those in need, but I thought it's a good thing to do. I'll cast something on and it will end up with someone and keep them warm. So a pattern that I had in my queue for a while was the, I think it's called ACAI Beanie by Claire Devine. And I'm not sure if it's a free pattern because I have her tea collection pattern book, but I think this was a free one that she had, but I'm not sure. I'll correct myself on the screen. But I had that in my queue, and I had a skein of, can I find it? No. This is some Heirloom Merino Magic, a DK weight, in a pale sort of baby blue. It's a 50-gram skein, and I cast on the smaller size of this hat, which is like the toddler size, I think, just because I thought that was the only thing that 50 grams would be enough for. And this is the start. So it has a twisted rib, and then again, it's a slip stitch type of pattern. I think, I mean, this is just a solid commercially dyed, so it doesn't have a lot of depth to it. I think with a variegated or hand-dyed semi-solid or any type of colorway like that would look really, really good with this. This is also okay, but it's not that interesting, I guess. I thought being a merino, it would be quite soft and suitable for a hat for a small child, but it does feel a bit rough. It might also be the textured pattern that makes it feel a bit rustic. But I thought I'll finish it and I'll give it a wash and see if it gets any softer. So I'm up to the point where I'm starting the crown decreases. But I am going to leave it like this for a while because Stash Dash starts to the 26th it starts, so that's Friday. I don't know. It's later this week it starts, so I have a few projects that I'm planning to finish after Stash Dash starts. But that's that hat that I'm making for someone I don't know. And because this pattern starts with an A, I can enter it in the April to August niche along with Bland Bonagon, Stina, a Swedish podcaster. So that's that one. I am still working on socks for my 7-year-old now. In a few days, she's 7. Drop some stitches. So making 2 at a time, magic loop, vanilla socks, 44 stitches I believe. And that's those. They're not very exciting to get some knitting on them like at the movies and things like that. But the yarn is not very nice to work with. Well, it's not a problem. It's a commercial strong sock yarn. But it's, after working with my hand-dyed sock yarn, it's just not very nice on the hands, I think. But it's okay. It's not a problem. So again, I have a little bit left and a cuff, and then I'll cast them off, but I'm waiting until Stash Dash has started. So that's nice. I'm so sorry about everything having a shade. Hopefully we have enough lighting in there. So the yarn that I'm using for that is the Salida that I bought in Sweden a couple of years ago now, I think. And then I have 2 more projects that I have been knitting on. One that I picked up again after not touching it for a while, because I was one of the things that I have been knitting on since last time was the test knit that I was doing with these gradients, the blue gradients here. These are my leftovers. I can now tell you that the test knit was for a mystery knit along, and it's the Gambia shawl by Jessica Gore, the Sweater Collective. And I can't remember now when the first clue is being released, but I think it's still another couple of weeks away. But I finished mine for the test knit and everything, so that took quite a bit of my knitting time. But once I was done, I picked up another shawl that was also test knit for Chara or Chara Made podcast. It's a brioche shawl, and the pattern has now been released. It's called a Fernshaw shawl. And for the test knit, I only had to do a few repeats, and then I put it down to make my other test knit, but I've picked it up again because I'm just really in love with these colours, and it's quite different to anything else that I'm working on. The colour, the yarn that I'm using is one dyed by Sandra of Craftfulness. She's on Etsy and she has a podcast on YouTube, and this is a skein of yarn I bought from My Spin on Things, I think she's called. I bought it at the smaller market at Bendigo in July last year. That was in the bowling club, I think. So those two I'm using together. And it was so funny, last time I showed this on the podcast, Shara was in contact with me and she said, "Oh, I think you made a mistake there." So you can see there's increases here in the middle. So I've done increases here twice correctly. And then you can see there's lines that go here. And I haven't made a decrease the correct... I've made increases out here instead of in here on the third repeat. And I couldn't quite figure it out, so I did it one more time incorrectly. Then I could see it, and I could sort of read my knitting and I could see what was happening. So then I made one pattern repeat correctly. So this is giving it a sort of a band here. It just gives it a bit of a different look, I guess. So I thought I've done twice correctly, twice incorrectly, and then I'll do twice correctly, and then maybe I'll do two incorrect again because it calls for eight repeats. But I'll just see. I'll make another repeat the correct way and see what it looks like, and I think it will still be fine. And there's not no way that I would undo brioche and eat again. I think it's fine. So that's what it looks like on this side. I think it's quite like it's kind of cool. The pattern is created doing it my way. So yes, I'm not having much luck with following patterns correctly at the moment. If you remember the sway shawl that I have been crocheting, also had a bit of a mistake in it, but it's just that I'm modifying them to be my own, I guess. So that's that one. I've worked quite a bit on that one. The rows are getting longer, so it's taking quite a while to get through a pattern repeat at the moment. And then the last thing that I have been working on is my Magical by Elena Nodal. I think I had only just started it last time. So this is a really cool pattern. Oh, I should do it like that so I don't get dark on my face. So yes, I've been making the Magical by Elena Nodal, and it's cool, the pattern, because you get different options. There's a more girly version, like they call it, which has a bit more of an A-line shape, and then a hem with a bow on one side, and the sleeves a little bit different. With boyish version, you get the rib sleeves, and it's straight body, and you can do with pockets, or with both versions, or without pockets, and you can do just a plain hemline, or with a bow, or with a button. So you can mix it up however you want it. So what I'm doing for my 7-year-old is the ribbed long sleeves because I think she would look a bit silly with what they call the girly sleeves. And I might make it a little bit, increase it a little bit. And then I was thinking the hemline with the bow on the side, but I'll see when I get to that point. So it's a really good pattern. I really recommend it. And this is where I'm at. So this is really pink, really bright pink. And I am using some Bendigo, I can't remember what they call it. I think it's discontinued, and I found it at the back room of Bendigo Woolen Mills in July last year. So you can see that they've handwritten on here that there's actually 222 grams, and it's $12 for this one. But it's meant to be 200 grams and 1350 originally, but in the back room of Bendigo, they just have all these odds and ends, bits and pieces, small skeins and overweight skeins, and just lots of different things. So this one is just called Pink, and it's an 8-ply. It's 30% wool, 69.6% cotton, and 0.4% lycra. So it has a bit of stretch in it. When I first worked on it, the first bit of the yoke, I felt like my hands were cramping a little bit. It does feel just like knitting with cotton, I think, or it did then. Since, I think I've loosened up my grip a bit, and it's going much better. Might also be because now I'm just doing straight stockinette in the round. I'm making the size 8 to 9-year-old. Okay, I had a phone call, so I had to stop for a bit because I'm recording on my phone. So this episode is going to be a bit funny. I had to stop a few times, and also I still do not have my new Mac computer, so I can't use iView. I've just been uploading to YouTube and doing just minimal editing on there. Seems to work fine, so hopefully you also think it's fine. There will be a change eventually. It's just everything is so busy at the moment, so finding time to go in with my old computer that is no longer starting and my new replacement, and get it all fixed is just taking a bit of time. Okay, I was talking about the magical top that I'm making for my 7-year-old. This is the back. It will have a button there. This is the front with the little cable on there. I'm going to make ribbed sleeves, long sleeves, and I'm just doing stockinette, increasing a little bit, and then I think you decrease before you do the hem to give it a bit of a, I don't know, girly shape, I'm not sure. But it's quite nice now when I'm working in the round. So this is also Bendigo stash from July last year, as was a few other things that I'm working on, like the Fernshawe shawl. One of those skeins is from Bendigo. So I'm hoping to have this one done so my daughter can wear it when we go to Bendigo this year. And just so that I'm working down the stash that I got there last time. That's all the knitting that I have been working on. Quite a bit still, I think. I've had some amazing me time since I last saw you. I've had, an empty house all to myself and a few times, and I've just thoroughly enjoyed it and stopped myself from doing anything silly like cleaning or anything like that and just enjoyed some time. Anyway, that was knitting. I have also amazingly done some spinning. We had quite a bit of rain on, was it Saturday? Well, on the weekend. And then the following day, it was beautiful, sunny, and I was able to sit outside with my spinning wheel and do some spinning. I'll show you. I'll put them here. So I have, this is a braid that I got. Sorry, I got it in Bendigo from Little Wood, Coral M. Stewart from Benalla. I got about 110 gram top from her in these very autumnal colours. And I just spun it like it wanted to be spun. It's a little bit thick and thin. It's not anything. It's not super thin. It's just whatever it wanted to do. And I just half the top, not lengthwise. I just half the, you know, in, it was still the full top, and I just tore it in half. And just spun straight from the top, so it could look quite, I don't know what it will look like when I ply it. I will make it 2-ply. It could all just look brown at the end, who knows, but it was nice to spin. So this I will also wait until stash starts to ply. So that's my little bit of spinning. It will be more interesting to show you once I have a skein of hand spun. Wearing my hand spun does inspire me to do more spinning and also to knit more with my hand spun, because I seem to, even though I don't spin very often, I still spin more than I knit with hand spun, which is weird. But I might have to cast on a hand spun project soon. So that's those things. Next up, I have a combination of future project and what's out of my dyeing pots sort of thing. And so I talked to you last time about the Hotel of Bees shawl. There's a crochet along happening. I think it's still on until the end of May, so there's not long left. I think it's by the Sherry Hart podcast and Betsy Make podcast. They host this Hotel of Bees shawl podcast. The Hotel of Bees crochet shawl, I can't remember the designer, but I'll put it on the screen, I think, or I'll put it in a link somewhere. Depends on how I can edit this. Anyway, let's move on. So I wanted to make that. It calls for a sport weight. I didn't have anything in my stash. I showed you last time some examples I had. I wasn't really happy with any of those. So I looked on Etsy for other indie dyers and see what they had. I could not really find anything that will work because I needed three colorways and I needed a certain amount. I found some really nice one, but there was only one skein, and for one of the colorways you need two skeins or 200 grams or just over 100 grams. Okay, more camera issues. Anyway, yes, I was in search for a sport weight to make this Hotel of Bees shawl. In the end, I could not decide on something. I was not 100% happy with anything that I could find. And there were not a lot of things that I did find. So I decided to get the Bendigo Woolen Mills Classic 5-ply and dye it myself. And that way I knew that I would have enough meterage. I knew that I would get three colors that would go well together. So that's what I did. The Bendigo Woolen Mills Classic range, I have used it before in the 8-ply, and I have used it in the 5-ply as well. And it's not my favorite yarn base. It's a crepe construction. And I have them here. These are my three skeins that I dyed up. I have it ready to start. So I did dye a yellow. And when I looked at the website for the Classic, there was really, I was going to buy them just commercially dyed, but then I thought with the pattern, I much prefer the semi-solid and variegated speckly colorways for the shawls. When I looked at the other one, sort of with silver and yellows, sort of speckled, and then one silver. So they are what I'm going to use. And like I said, it's a crepe construction yarn. Not my favorite. I have used it before in the 8-ply and it's okay. I did a baby or a child's cardigan out of it and that was fine. It's okay to work with, not a problem. Dyeing it, I could really feel the difference to other yarn bases that I dye that are not crepe construction. And this is like a superwash. Is this a superwash crepe construction? And it just feels really, does not feel very woolly anymore. Feels like it's taking all of those characteristics of wool out of the wool when they're made of yarn. But we'll see how we go. I thought I'll try it out and see how it works when I crochet it up in the shawl. So that's a combination of what's coming up next and what I have been dyeing. So when I did those, I did two each. So I have another one each of those colorways, and because I could fit it into the pots when I did it, I also did a set on my Victoria sock. So I will list that in my Etsy shop eventually. So they're those things. And now I think I'll just go through a few things that I have in my Etsy shop at the moment before my camera goes unhappy again. Okay. I must have been inspired by the darker season here and the shorter days and everything, because I went a bit crazy with dyeing greys. So some examples of what I did with these blues with a glazing and over dye of black. I call them Zombie Moon. I really like them. I really like that glazing effect when you put grey and black on top of a brighter colour. So that's the Zombie Moon that I dyed up, and at the same time I did the same sort of thing but with pink as the base colour that I over dyed with the grey black. And I call this Vampire Moon, I think. And then I felt like doing some speckles, and some favourites of mine are the Fairy Light Speckled. And these are all on the Victoria sock, the 80 Merino 20 nylon base. So there's Fairy Lights that I did, and I did the Sea Spray, Speckled Sea Spray. It It's one that I did recently. So I did that. I really like that too, with the greens, black, and a bit of yellow in there. And then I want to do some other old favorites, and one of my absolute favorite colorway is the Raindrops colorway. So I did a Victoria sock in the Raindrops colorway. It is like a denim blue, and it has some yellow, green, and purple speckles in it. So when I did it on the Victoria sock, at the same time I did one on the Tassie fingering, which is the white gum wool fingering weight yarn. And as you can see, it goes as always. It's much more muted, and you don't really get speckles in the same way. Here are some yellow ones that have turned out as actual speckles, but otherwise they normally blend in a bit more. And another one I did on both was my blueberry smoothie colorway. So this is on the Victoria sock. So it's really deep, bright purples and blues. And this one was really hard to photograph for Etsy. It has like turquoise and purple, blue, and I did it on the white gum wool fingering weight as well. And you can see it's just much lighter and more blended colors. Oh, it's so soft. So I did those, and then I decided I wanted to try to do the watercolors colorway that I did just as a, I used some leftovers from some other dyeing, and got this really beautiful skein that I call watercolors, and it was very popular. So I wanted to try it again, and I tried it on the white gum wool fingering weight base, and I think it turned out really nice. So I call that watercolors, and I did the storm colorway, which is just a gray. I also did that on the white gum wool fingering. I think they go really well together. Yeah. I haven't dyed the white gum wool for a while, so it was really nice to do that again. After dyeing all the sock yarn up and dyeing. And then what I also did was some of the DK weight white wool. And I can't remember which one. I think I might have shown you some last time, but I just did a few different fun colors. This one I really like. It's a bit crazy. I think this would look really nice in a hat with a bit of a textured pattern maybe. And it's so soft. So nice. And yes, I have like a blue and a pinky gray, yellow. And this is blue with yellow and pink speckles in it. So there are some of the things, and of course I have mini skeins. These are the mini skeins that are on my Etsy shop at the moment, 10 of them together. Really like the yellow one. And this one was really cool. It's like a peachy, pinky peachy color, and it has purple specks in it. Really nice. So this 10 in a set, they're up there on Etsy. These are a couple of skeins I have not listed yet. I dyed these when I did the Hotel of Bees skeins. So they're just speckled with purple, pink, green, and yellow. And you see, even on the white gum wool base, I've got some really cool speckles on there. And this is the Victoria sock base. So they're going to be listed sometime soon. And then lastly, I have a few gradient sets up on my Etsy shop. These are the ones, I call them fading sets because they're not actually like a gradient with just one same color of them. But yes, this is one I call it deep sea or sea something, I can't remember. But they go from like a darker gray, a green that is like over dye with a glazed with a black gray, and then to lighter blue green. So I have that, and this is another one that is purples. And then I have a turquoise one and a pink one, I think. And I did those because when I was dyeing my gradient for the mystery knit along, I wanted to do just a few extra to try to have them in my shop with my leftovers. I now have 50 grams left of each, about approximately. And then I had these mini skeins. Well, they're about 20 grams each of a purple gradient. So I'm going to try to have the four color gradient of 50 gram of each, and then I have a five color gradient of 20 grams of each, and somehow mix them up. And I'm thinking if I have dark blue to light blue, and in between the light purple to dark purple, so that go the gradients go the opposite way, and somehow stripe them in a shawl or something. I'm not sure. I just have this idea. I don't have a pattern in mind necessarily, but we'll see. I have other things to work on first. But yes, that's all the things surrounding me. Yes, I have quite a bit in the shop at the moment. And yes, doing a lot of knitting. It's just the season for it. It's cold, it's days are short and it's dark, and it just feels like the right time for knitting and having a cup of tea and enjoying those things. So I think with my issues with the phone and everything and the camera, I've been spending quite a bit of time on this already, so I won't do a section on my yarn research, but it is coming up in future episodes. I have been looking into different Australian mills and sort of boutique yarns and single farm yarns and things like that. I find it very interesting and a really good thing. So I have a few things I can show you, but I will do it probably next time. Yes, I'll have to do that. So thank you for watching. Thank you for being part of this. I'll see you next time. So take care, everyone. Bye.